Hello. In this WAGO tutorial, we will show you how to automatically send log data via the FTP client in the WAGO Energy Data Management application. In the basic tutorial linked in the video description, we recommended logging all data point values with the full logger and saving them to an SD card as a CSV file. This provides a very good backup of the data, independent of the controller memory, which is often required for energy audits. As the storage capacity of an SD card is limited, it must either be replaced regularly or the data must be downloaded manually using FTP client software. Another very elegant method is to automatically send the files to an FTP server according to a defined schedule. To demonstrate this, we have the following structure. We will use the same PFC with the WAGO Energy Data Management settings, logger and log files from the basic tutorial. This PFC 200 will then send the log files of the full logger to an FTP server as an FTP client in WAGO Energy Data Management according to a defined schedule. In practice, the FTP server is usually provided by the organization's IT department, which also defines the security requirements and provides any necessary certificates, releases, ports, and so on. In our case, we simulate the FTP server with another PFC 200. The FTP connection is a password-protected SFTP connection for which port 22 is enabled. Firstly, we need to configure the PFC to run as the FTP server, and then we need to enable the FTP service in the web-based management. This can be found in the Configuration tab in the Ports and Services menu, then Network Services. Simply tick the box in the FTP section and submit. Now we need a file path where the FTP client can send the log files. We will use an FTP client software to create a new folder on the PFC for this purpose. And copy the file path. The PFC is now ready to receive data as an FTP server. Now we need to enable the FTP service on the EDM PFC. As energy data management normally opens directly when the IP address is entered in the browser, we add the /WBM suffix to the IP address and the web-based management opens. Regarding the FTP server, we check the box for FTP service active and switch to EDM by re-entering the IP address without the suffix. The file management menu is located at the top of the file tab. The FTP connection must also be enabled in EDM. We then select the type of FTP used to access the server. This is an SFTP connection, and in our case, authentication is by password. Depending on the security requirements of the connection, the required type can be selected. The area here then adapts accordingly, and all the information such as certificates and so on can be entered. We then enter the server address and the FTP server port, as well as the username and password. Leave the timeout and keep alive at their default values, which is fine for most applications. To use active FTP, this checkbox must be selected and the appropriate port specified. If this box is checked, UTC time will be used to determine the execution time. If retries are specified, we specify the number of transfer attempts. The FTP client is now configured and we can create an FTP job. The aim is to send all the CSV files created by the full logger to the FTP server every day at 12 o'clock. To do this, we open the configuration menu with the configure button. We tick the enable box and select the full logger. For remote path, we enter the file path to the folder we previously created on the PFC FTP server. Similar to the loggers, we can create up to 10 schedule channels and enable them here. We still need to create the required schedule channel. Nevertheless, we select the first one here, confirm with OK and the FTP job is created. We create a schedule channel by clicking on Schedule. As we have just selected channel 1, we also enable channel 1 here, enter the desired time of 12 o'clock, tick the boxes Monday to Sunday and close the window. The transfer list window now lists all the CSV files created by the full logger. To test the FTP connection, select a file and click Send. If everything is configured correctly, the file will be transferred to the FTP server, and we can now find it in the newly created folder using the FTP client software. The file has been transferred, so the automatic transfer at 12 o'clock should also work. So we wait until 12 o'clock. And dial into the FTP server using the FTP client software. Now we find all the logger files in our FTP folder. The data has been successfully and automatically transferred and saved. The only thing we have to worry about now is that the SD card in the EDM controller will eventually fill up and not be able to store any more data. The file management system has an automatic file data cleanup function for this purpose. If this is enabled, a daily check will be made at 3 a.m. to see if there is any data older than the time set here, which will then be deleted accordingly. The time set here must of course match the size of the SD card and the amount of logged data. This means that we have 4 time variables that we can use to optimize the data archiving of the full logger. Firstly, the time interval at which the data logger records the current values and writes them to a CSV file. Second, the time when a new CSV file is created. Thirdly, the time when the stored CSV files are sent to the FTP server. And finally, the automatic deletion of old CSV files on the EDM controller's SD card. And that concludes the tutorial on FTP transfer in WAGO Energy Data Management. Please give us a thumbs up if the video helped you, subscribe to the channel and contact the WAGO Support Center if you have any questions.